city in West Africa.
I just can't believe that I'm standing right in front of the first university in West Africa. No, let me tell you something. I didn't even know that the first university in West Africa
was in Freetown. Yeah.
This is what Africa to the world have done to me. Yeah. And I want to say thank you so much for bringing me here. Yeah. But you know what I always do? I travel to learn. And I'm here to learn. And I know the people following me are also here to learn with me.
Yeah.
Can you be our lecturer for today?
Well, this is the first ever university in West Africa.
Amazing.
That was founded by the Anglican Church Mission in the year 1827.
1827?
February 1827.
Were you born that time?
I wasn't. My mother was not born now.
Your mother was not born.
At all.
Wow.
But yeah, ever since then, this university has been the pride of Sierra Leone and West Africa as a whole. Yeah, because the name, the Athens of West Africa, I'm sure I've heard it. Yeah,
like,
you've heard that. Came as a result of the fact that people around Africa, the whole of West Africa, used to come here to study. Because this university was producing elites all around the world. And so it was like something good for people to experience. So we had people from Ghana, Nigeria, Liberia, they were all coming here.
My Ghanaian brothers were here.
Yes.
They came to study.
Yes,
here.
Our parents told us that. Back then, they had loads of other West African people here coming here to study. So this is the great, of course, this is the ancient structure.
Yeah.
But it still has loads of memories, as you can see.
I think it's still strong. But can I find out who was the first student who studied in here?
The first student was Bishop Ajayi Crowder.
Ajayi
Crowder.
Ajayi sounds like a Nigerian name.
Oh, well, for us here, we say it's a Creole name. But you know, Creoles here is a blend of Ghanaians, Nigerians. Yes. Oh, because Africans, we're all the same, so
yeah, in one way or the same, other. But according to history, I think like people living in Freetown are basically from different African countries. Due to the slavery. So I think Ajayi is a Nigerian name.
Yes, because they went there, they gave birth, and then when the white people decided to release them, some of them came here. Some of them came to Sierra Leone, whilst others went to different African countries. Yeah, so the ones we had here, we call them the Creoles.
Wow. Yeah. This is a beautiful structure, man. I would love to see how it looks like in the year 1827, huh?
Yeah, I guess it was beautiful because it still looks
it's
beautiful.
It's still beautiful.
Yeah.
And, you know, like, do you watch this movie, Harry Potter?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
It looks like a Western style of university.
Yeah. And actually, this is the first Western model university in West Africa, the whole of West Africa. And then they used to address it as the Oxford of West Africa.
Oh, wow.
You know, because it's the first university to open its doors to other African countries to come here.
This university was here before University of Sierra Leone?
No, this is Frobe College. But the thing is, yes, as time goes by, they had another faculty, they had other faculties, and so it becomes bigger. And so now we have three different colleges making up the University of Sierra Leone.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is just Frobe College.
Okay.
But when you talk about the University of Sierra Leone, you have Frobe College, you have IPAM, which is a business school, sort of. Then you have the medical school, College of Medicine.
Wow.
So it comprises of the three that gives you University of Sierra Leone. So this Frobe College was founded by the Anglican Mission in Sierra Leone, supported by the governor then, who is Charles McCarthy.
Charles McCarthy.
Yes.
That was the former governor.
Yes, well, way back, yes, during those days, yeah, he was the governor. Yeah, so he actually supported them, you know.
I want to say thank you so much. But we want to know what you do. We want to follow you. How do we follow you?
I have a YouTube channel.
Oh, amazing. And what's the name of your YouTube channel?
Antoinette Nunu George.
Antoinette Nunu George. All you need to do is to go to your YouTube channel, go check it out, go
subscribe.
Go support the movement. Let
and I'm a social worker. Go there for all the gender activist things,
exactly.
You know.
Exactly. That's how we do it.
Yeah.
So, boy, Mr. Ghana, baby. And I want to say thank you so much for watching this amazing episode. Today, I'm definitely going to go in there. I'm going to have my degree once again at the first university in West Africa.
I am Maya.
Hey, hello. What's up? This is Antoinette. your Sierra Leonean babe. I'm happy that Odera is here with Mr. Ghana, baby. I am Maya. I'm so happy you guys made it. It's a pleasure having you.
So what have you been doing today? What am I doing?
Africa to the world. This is a hard work, man. It's not easy. We've been up and down. So anytime you see Mode Maya's video, man, just give it a thumbs up, because behind the scenes, you see what goes on behind the scenes. You just have to give a thumbs up. It's hard work. It's not easy. Yeah.